So this past week, we had the opportunity to bring the Pawtism Project here to Saraland Elementary. And the Pawtism Project's a special initiative that we started many years ago. The idea was to bring service dogs who are in training, training to be a variety of different therapy dogs to use with adults and students, many students with disabilities, whether it's a seizure alert dog, a specific service dog for an individual child, a comfort or anxiety dog, or whatever the type of service that was needed, but to bring these dogs in and through special education classrooms to help get them exposure and opportunity to work with various students with disabilities. This past week, we brought some of those dogs into Saraland Elementary School to work with two of our classes and a variety of different students. And what we saw was pretty unique. Initially, several of the students who were anxious about our dogs, through some directed interaction and some reinforcement on our behalf, really warmed up to the dogs, had an opportunity to connect with them on a personal level, but also to overcome some of that anxiety. And although that seems like a small thing, anytime any student can overcome fear or doubt or hesitation, it's such an accomplishment for them, and know that there's other things that they may be fearful of or anxious of or hesitant of that they can overcome. The other part that was really positive was we saw students who are super excited to be exposed and around the dogs and engage them, and it brought out some higher communication skills. For two of our students in particular, one who has very limited verbal skills, she actually spoke the word doggy, which is so rare for her to use her mouth to communicate. She's learning sign language and various ways to speak and initiate, and the dog really helped facilitate and bring some of that language out with her from a novel new activity that seemed to be something that was a little different. Another one who was using an assistive technology device was very clear what he wanted. He said, "I want the dog. I want to play." And helping develop and expand his language is something that's super positive that we always want to do. And so a lot of times people think about dogs coming into a school as an opportunity, just kind of as a simple come and go, but there's so much more when we think about the idea of servicing students in many ways. And so it was great for us to work with the Tuberville's to come in and them bring in those two dogs that they were training, Boo and Taft, and allow them to work with our students. When the dogs come in the classroom, everyone in the room lights up. From the adults, from the typical students, from the students with disabilities, it is an immediate bridge that connects kids to one another. There's no barrier anymore because everybody's attention is focused on one thing, the dogs. The dogs allow comfort and opportunity to be thrown to the wayside about somebody who may be hesitant or unsure, and the dog provides that vehicle to be a bridge. A lot of times students with disabilities exhibit various behaviors that sometimes make them unapproachable. But when a dog's in the room, everybody's willing to approach. They're not looking at, you know, this person makes this noise, or this person moves their hands in a unique way, or this individual does certain things different than I do. They're just a bunch of kids who want to play with a dog. There's so many positives about the service dogs being engaged with the students in the schools and the opportunity for that to continue on a regular basis. I think as we continue to look at the Pawtism Project and helping these service dogs get exposure and opportunity into schools as they get ready to prepare to go be with their owners, we look and see the benefits of those who are here. The kids, the teachers, the adults, the parents, the students, everyone sees the positives in this initiative. And so we're excited to continue the Pawtism Project and look forward to more opportunities as they come.